Hi, I'm just so happy to be with all of you today on the special and important day when we remember all those who are victims of abortion and all those who suffer because of the loss of children through abortion. Last November, when the bishops met in Baltimore, they voted about what is the preeminent priority for the church, especially as we look forward to leadership in our country. And they overwhelmingly agreed, and I'm happy to tell you, I voted absolutely in favor of this, that the preeminent priority is the ending of the threat of abortion in our nation. They said there's three reasons for this. First, because it's a direct attack on human life, which is never something that God wants for any of us. Second, because it is attack at the very heart of the family, at the sanctuary of the family. And we all know that the family in our culture is under great attack to begin with. And thirdly, because of the horrendous numbers of children that have been lost through the sin and the crime of abortion. More children have been aborted in our nation than all of the victims of both World War I and World War II put together, far more than that. So that tells us how important this is. I say it's also important because of the need for the healing of hearts, especially for women who find that a pregnancy may be a burden or may be difficult. We pray for the healing of their hearts. We hold them in our hearts with great love. We pray also for fathers of children who are unborn, that they may see this child in their life as a blessing and not a burden. And finally, we pray for all healing in our nation that needs to be healed in so much that all of the attacks on human life may end, whatever they may be. And as Father Stubna so beautifully said, what a blessed day to come together to remember all of this and to hold it up to God in prayer, that on the feast of the Holy Name of Mary, the Mother of God and our Mother. If you ever get the thought that you can't make a difference, immediately dismiss it. Because every one of us can make a difference for the cause of life in our nation. And we remember especially that one individual back in the 16th century in Mexico, who was the smallest of the small, the least of the least, and yet through his witness to God's love and mercy and life, attacks on human life, and that is Juan Diego, as Our Lady appeared to him at Guadalupe. Through his courageous voice, a culture of death and violence became a culture of life and love. So, every one of us has a real duty and a real role to play in all of this. Know that I keep you all in my prayers, and I'm so grateful for your dedication to the cause of human life. Every human life is precious in the eyes of God. Our lives, the lives of the poorest of the poor, the lives of those who are on the margins of society, and especially the lives of those who have no voice, who have no face,